Today, in India, if you want to buy a tech gadget, what you can get for this? I know you can get some of the tech accessories like earphones for this, but do you know you can get even a full-fledged feature phone for this? Please keep watching this video till the end, because in this video, I'll be showing you a feature phone which costs even less than 300 rupees. My name is Oni and I welcome you to my YouTube channel, Oni Online. Yes, we are actually talking about this Detel D1. The device is completely made in India by an Indian company, as you can see here. This device is available for ₹299 only on the company website, and the link for which is given below in the description. Now, without any further delay, let's quickly unbox this device and have a look in this. So, let's get started.
As you can see, this is the box pack of this device. Let me just remove the outer wrap and let's continue with the unboxing. So, as you can see, there are some specification overview mentioned over here. If you want to read, you can always pause the video and read. This side, there are some information regarding the IMEI and all these things, and the device is made in India, as you can see here, and the model number is D1 mentioned over here. The MRP quoted on the box is ₹699 only. So without any further delay, now let's quickly unbox the device. So just let me break the seal. Let's check what's there inside the box. So the first thing we found in the box is the device itself. For the time being, let's keep it aside and let's check what else do we get inside the box. So apart from the handset, we are getting this charger and the battery. And the battery, as you can see, and this warranty card, though much information is not available on this warranty card. So let's keep these things aside. First, let's take a look in the charger. This is the charger, and as you can see, this is the old Nokia style charger. And if we talk about the charger rating, this is a 0.5 amp charger, so this is a very normal and basic charger. And now let's have a look in the battery itself. As you can see, the battery is a 650 mAh battery. And now let's take a look at the phone itself. This is the device, as you can see, and if I am not wrong, the design resembles the old Nokia 103 quite well, as you can see here. Let me peel off this protective film from the display, and now let's insert the battery and the SIM card. I am inserting my SIM card. Yeah, now let's insert the battery. After that, we'll power on the device. The phone is ready to boot up. Yeah, this comes with a monochrome display, as you can see.
Now let me give you a physical overview of this phone. On the front side, there is the earpiece, and below the earpiece there is a detailed branding. As you can see, here is the model number mentioned, that is D1, and below that you have the 1.44 inch white backlit monochrome LCD display, and below the display there is a T9 rubberized alphanumeric keypad, as you can see. On the top there is a 3.5 mm headphone jack, apart from this LED torch light. On the right side, there is nothing but the socket for charging the device. In the bottom, there is the microphone, and here is the hole where you can attach a strap to this phone. On the left side, there is absolutely nothing, as you can see. And on the bottom, there is a detailed branding beside the loudspeaker, as you can see here. The phone resembles that old Nokia 103 quite well in terms of look and feel. There is absolutely nothing much to talk about the specification. As you know, the display is 1.44 inch white backlit monochrome LCD display, and the keypad is also white backlit rubberized keypad. And this device is a single SIM dual band GSM feature phone. This is not even a dual SIM device, and this device comes with a FM radio. So this much is for the specification, and now let's check the call quality of this device. Let me first call this phone from this phone, so that you can get an idea about the ringtone volumes. So just let me give a call to this phone, and yes, the phone is ringing, as you can see. This is the highest possible ringtone volume you can get in this device. I am getting an incoming call in this device, and let me answer this. Hi Pankaj. Yeah, tell me, how are you? The SIM is in my new Detel D1, which is a 300 rupees phone. And now you tell me, is my voice audible or how is the call quality? Okay, let me put you on loudspeaker so my audience can get an idea about the loudspeaker. Yeah, so you are in on the loudspeaker. Please say something to my audience. Okay, so for the price point, we would say that it's okay, right?
Yeah, it's okay.
Okay, so now let me first finish the video and we'll be chatting after that. Okay, bye bye. Now, let me call another teammate of mine and now let's check how is the call quality this time. Hi, actually I am calling you from my new 300 rupees phone, which is Detel D1. And now I am putting you on loudspeaker. And please say my audience, how is the call quality? Okay, and so the call quality is good?
Yeah,
okay, so and is my voice audible?
Yes.
Okay. So considering the price point, we would say the call quality is good, right?
Yes.
Okay, and anything you want to say for my audience? Oh, great, thank you, thanks for supporting me. As you have seen, the call quality in this device is really good. The earpiece volume is great, so as the loudspeaker volume. The both the speakers produces good loud volume, so you will not have any problem while calling. Now, let's talk about the pros and cons. So talking about pros, the first pros I found in this device is the call quality. The call quality is really good and you will not have any problem during the call as you have seen. The second pros I found is its battery life. This device gives a decent standby time of 2 to 3 days along with a talk time of 3.5 to 4 hours. Also the monochrome display is very crisp and clear, so that is also very user friendly for the aged people. And the keypad is also very spacious, so that is also very good for the aged people. And if we talk about the cons, the FM radio is really not that clear. The build quality of this device is really not that great, though it feels sturdy and durable. Apart from this, we found there are absolutely no cons in this device. Now it's the time to give the final verdict about this device. If you are looking for a fully featured feature phone, you can definitely go for this. And this device can be used as an excellent secondary device. That's all for this video. If you have any question, please do let me know through the YouTube comment section below, or you can ask me directly through my Twitter handle. Please don't forget to give this video a like and don't forget to share this video. Also, please do subscribe to my channel if you have not. Signing off, this is Oni, and I hope to see you in my next video. Thank you for watching.